Is the mysterious Project Titan Apple Car a real thing? Bugatti have issued 3 recalls on the Veyron, and I'll tell you why. And the new 2017 Ford GT application and configurator are live for the next month. All that and more coming up right now on This Week in Cars. Hello, 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 car lovers worldwide, and welcome to This Week in Cars. To those of you who have heard of or seen the supposed Apple Car, I am very pleased to inform you that it is all a hoax. Not real. It's fake. Motor Trend magazine had this car digitally rendered in order to gain publicity for their company and also to stir interest in the public. Motor Trend has also been hyping up the car through various forms of social media, but the case has now been closed and the Apple Car is determined to be not real. Now, this doesn't mean that Apple will never make a car, but it's highly unlikely considering they're a cell phone company, and they're most likely gonna stick to that. However, if they do for some reason begin to produce cars, I would expect the models to continually grow bigger and bigger just like their phones did, from the 5 to the 6 to the 6 Plus, they just get bigger. But how big is too big? All jokes aside, Apple still do have their mysterious Project Titan, which is shrouded in a bunch of secrecy and no one really knows what's going on or what it could possibly result in the future. But there are many hints supposing that it could be an Apple Car. Anyways, aside from that, I don't really ever anticipate seeing an Apple Car going into production just because of how unlikely it is from a cell phone company. The brand new 2017 Ford GT application and configurator are now live on the Ford website. With nearly endless customizable options, the Ford GT configurator is the kind of website that you could just spend hours on picking out your perfect spec, whether or not you actually have the $450,000 to purchase the actual car. The application to purchase the new 2017 Ford GT was also released a few days ago, and it will be open for 1 month. Production is slated for about 250 cars a year, and this application is good for the first 2 years, or 500 cars. Now, what everybody wants to know is what the price of this car is going to be, and the base price is set to be around $450,000. But price is not the only thing you have to take into consideration if you want to buy the new 2017 Ford GT. Along with giving up a massive sum of money, Ford also want their prospective owners to be driving the car a whole lot once they receive delivery, and they also want them to have a semi-large social media presence so they can advertise the car in their social medias and gain Ford more popularity. They also want you to have a history with owning Ford cars, so anywhere from a Ford Focus to preferably the Ford GT or GT40, that'll really put you high on the list if you've owned one of those. Now, that doesn't mean if you've never owned a Ford, then you have no chance of getting the Ford GT, because Ford also wants to expand their customer base with this car, and they will be selling a portion of the cars to people who have never owned a Ford before. So hop on that application if you're interested in buying, and hop on that configurator if you're interested in buying as well, but you don't have nearly enough money. The speed limit on the famed Nürburgring in Germany has finally been lifted, and makers of super quick track cars like the Koenigsegg 1-to-1 and Viper ACR are excited to put their cars to the test on the track to see if they can beat the lap record. The fastest official lap time of the Nürburgring is currently held by the Radical SR8 Le Mans, with a time of 6 minutes and 48 seconds. However, the Pagani Zonda Revolution does have an unofficial lap time of 6 minutes 37 seconds, but that cannot be confirmed. I'm really excited to see what numbers Dodge and Koenigsegg will put up after they race around the track, and maybe some other cars flying under the radar will come out of the darkness and show themselves into the light with some astonishing lap times. The speed limit was placed on the Nürburgring in an attempt to increase safety, but all it really did was defer interest away from the track. So now the speed limit has lifted and competition can commence. Even cars like the Bugatti Veyron are subject to recalls, and this famed figurehead for Bugatti has been recalled for any one of 3 reasons. For some, the fuel gauge displays that there's more fuel left in the tank than there actually is. And for others, the positive battery cable and the connection to the alternator are susceptible to corrosion. Lastly, the third problem that Bugatti mechanics need to fix is the aluminium plating on the underside of the car that can corrode and potentially fall off the bottom of the car while in motion and cause a hazard to other drivers on the road. If you are lucky enough to call yourself an owner of a Bugatti Veyron, then make sure you take your car down to your local Bugatti dealer so they can fix these issues for you before they become real-life problems. The Hennessy Venom GT Spider has officially earned the title of fastest production convertible ever made by reaching a massive top speed of 265.6 miles per hour. This beats the previous convertible top speed record holder, which was the Bugatti Veyron Vitesse's 254 miles per hour, by a massive 11 mile per hour difference. The record was broken by the American tuning company's Beast at the Naval Air Station Lemoore in California. 3 world record editions of the Venom GT Spider are going to be produced in honor of the accomplishment, and they're going to cost about $1.3 million each. As all these top speed records are continually being broken, it makes me wonder how fast cars are going to be able to go in the future, in 10 years, 20 years, with all the advancing technology, and it also makes me wonder if there will ever be a speed that no car can ever surpass, basically just because of physical limitations. Top Marks is currently underway in Monaco, and the cars that have been brought out by the events are absolutely jaw-dropping. With the Koenigsegg Agera R, Bugatti Chiron, and hundreds of other supercars and hypercars driving around in the south of France, this is definitely an event I look forward to attending sometime in my future, and I recommend it for anybody else who enjoys seeing a higher ratio of exotic cars to normal cars than anywhere else on the planet. And I look forward to seeing what other cars are going to show up in the coming days. The press pictures of the Aston Martin Vantage GTA have now been released, and this is easily the best looking and most hardcore Aston Martin Vantage we've ever seen. The new Vantage GTA boasts race-bred aerodynamics, extreme carbon fiber bodywork, and a razor-sharp chassis setup to help it dance around a racetrack, and prices start around $200,000. Its 4.7-liter V8 produces 440 horsepower, and it can go from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 4.4 seconds. Also, the Vantage GTA can come in either a 6-speed manual or a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic, depending on your driving preference. Thank you all so much for watching another episode of This Week in Cars, and make sure to tune in again next Sunday for another update on news in the car world. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more. This has been Jake, and drive safe.